This is The Feed, brought to you by insert sponsor here. When you work in Silicon Valley, you can enjoy perks such as getting your eggs frozen and catching Z's in a nap pod. Also, the average engineer in Silicon Valley makes around $200,000 a year. Pizza like that. But there's a dark side to Silicon Valley that includes some Mad Men-style racial and sexual stereotyping. New boss, same as the old boss, I guess. Bro culture is a prevalent thing that exists even after the keg is tapped at the Kappa Dig Dug Bloopy House. I explored bro culture myself.
We were knee-deep with that electronic dance music, and my vision was filled with slits and crop tops.
Whether it be the hard partying ways of Travis Kalanick or the ridicule endured by Ellen Powell, there are plenty of stories besmirching the rapid growth of tech culture. But now, there is evidence that goes beyond the anecdotal. Google was recently sued by the Department of Labor. Google provides cloud data to federal agencies, so they are required to provide hiring data, which Google has denied to hand over. The Labor Department wants to run an audit of Google's equal opportunity hiring practices. Currently, the information is not made public, and it's uncertain what the Department of Labor knows. But the accusation is that there is a pay gap, which Google has vehemently denied. Let's hear from the workers themselves. Hear what they have to say.
Yeah.
So Ashley, you're looking kind of tense today.
Please don't touch me.
In a recent study completed by the Oakland's Catbor Center for Social Impact, 2,000 tech leavers were interviewed about what drove them to voluntarily leave what would be considered a secure job opportunity. Like, my job doesn't offer nap pods or frozen eggs. The number one reason why employees left: unfairness.
It's the media again. I get the most unfair media. Nobody ever even called me. This is the first time I've been asked this question.
Unfairness included inappropriate comments from men towards women, micromanaging certain groups over others, or simply being ignored. All groups surveyed expressed mistreatment. The main group, white men, noted unfair treatment from management, while minority groups complained of stereotypical mistreatment, like a black woman who was surveyed said her employer assumed she knew Ebonics. This isn't just personally damaging, it hurts the wallet too. The Catbor Center estimates that people quitting leads to a big turnover cost, which climbed up to $16 billion a year. Nowadays, the tech world is mostly white men, which makes sense given our nation's history, but that's changing ever slowly. Let this be a call to action for Chicago. We're not nearly as scrutinized as Silicon Valley, but we are growing. With hundreds of millions of investment each quarter, Chicago could become synonymous name for tech innovation. That's why it's important that bro culture be replaced with adult culture. It's time to grow up, boys, and before you turn 40, I'm talking to you, Kalanick. That's right, Chicago, you're on the clock. You got the ball. So instead of sexually harassing your coworkers and soliciting them for sex, why not try to be an adult? I know we're human and prone to err, but I'm just saying, give it a chance. Anywho, there'll be less humans working to do the jobs, but maybe the drones will sexually harass as well. This week's Technori shout-out goes to Corvus Robotics. Headed by Northwestern engineer Jackie Wu, Corvus Robotics is creating AI drones that will work the graveyard shift in warehouses, checking stock and cutting prices. So drones just aren't for YouTube vlogs anymore. They're finally old enough to be put to work and war, but we won't talk about that here. That's it for the show. Don't harass your office mates this week, okay?